As of December 5th of 2022, there are 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting, including three which are in Antarctica. One of these erupting volcanoes in Antarctica is the famed Mount Erebus, which is one of only a select few volcanoes in the world to contain an active lava lake. This lava lake periodically produces moderate magnitude explosions which hurl bombs of molten rock beyond the crater rim and onto layers of surrounding snow. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Italy, Mount Etna produced a new eruption, causing lava to flow onto snow. Meanwhile, in New Zealand, an unusually large earthquake struck the Taupo supervolcano, and it was believed to be volcanic in origin. And, in Hawaii, the Mauna Loa volcano produced its first eruption since 1984, ending a 38-year-long eruption drought. For context, Mauna Loa is the world's largest active volcano, towering to 13,679 feet or 4,169 meters above sea level, and covers a little more than half of the landmass on Hawaii's Big Island. Mauna Loa is a highly active shield volcano which, during the last 3,000 years, has erupted about once every 6 years on average. It produced a new effusive eruption on November 25th at 11:30 p.m. local time, creating a series of lava fountains which erupted significant quantities of lava across the volcano's summit caldera. Some of this lava then overflowed the caldera and spilled onto the southwestern slopes of the volcano, but did not travel very far as magma began propagating up the northeast rift zone. Within several hours, three fissures emerged between 1 and 3.5 miles down the rift, each erupting significant quantities of lava at a rate which altogether was likely around 249 cubic meters per second. This sent lava flows down the northern slope of Mauna Loa, which although not placing any homes at risk, did present a potential separate headache. The flow had a chance of advancing onto Route 200, which interconnects the two opposite sides of the Big Island. A fourth fissure eventually developed, but fissure number 3 remained the main focus of activity. In the past several days, the advance of lava towards this road has continued to slow and is now 2.25 miles or 3.6 kilometers away. Meanwhile, in Italy, the now snow-covered Mount Etna volcano produced a new eruption beginning on November 27th. However, this eruption was quite small, involving a small vent which erupted a modest volume of lava on the volcano's eastern flank. Although lava is still erupting as of several days later, it remains unlikely to affect any significant areas downslope. However, it is possible that this minor eruption signals the beginning of a new episode of eruptive activity which could migrate to one of Etna's summit craters. In New Zealand, the Taupo supervolcano has been at a raised but still low alert level of 1 since September 20th of 2022. This change was made in response to an abnormal level of earthquakes occurring in combination with a minor amount of volcanic uplift. Although earthquakes have continued at a high rate since then, they slowly waned in frequency. Just before midnight on November 30th, a magnitude 5.4 earthquake struck around the volcano's magma chamber at a depth of 7.8 kilometers or 4.8 miles per the U.S. Geological Survey. Although this quake represented the largest to occur in several years at Taupo, quakes of this magnitude during unrest episodes at Taupo are somewhat common, as seen by a similar magnitude 5.1 earthquake in 2019. Since magma or magmatic fluids are currently intruding into the crust, it has pushed up a section of ground within the Taupo complex. This in turn placed increased stress on several fault lines. Eventually, this strain became so great that a slip occurred, generating what is known as a volcano tectonic earthquake. In other words, the magnitude 5.4 earthquake was simply an unusually large example of the hundreds of smaller earthquakes which have been occurring at Taupo throughout 2022. It is unlikely to generate a volcanic eruption anytime soon. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. I would like to give a special thanks to A. Eschenbacher for allowing me to use several of his photos of Mount Erebus in Antarctica. Additionally, I would like to thank my patrons and YouTube members for supporting this channel.